Alright guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. In today's tutorial, I will be showing you guys how to cartoon your own picture. In our previous class, I made a video on how to sketch, but error occurred while trying to upload the other part of the video. So I just think I should move on with another video, like doing a fresh video from the scratch. So let's get started. Click on your Autodesk. Whenever you click on your Autodesk, this is the interface you get. Then what you do is you click on your first two, which is your menu, where you set and import or resize your canvas. Then click on your new sketch. Click on custom. The size we'll be using, the size of our canvas will be 1080 by 1350. So let's enter it from here. 1020, but let's do it from scratch. 1080 by 1350. Yes, accept it. Always mark this keep proportion. Okay, here is the image size. This is our working environment. So let's import our image. Click here, the second two. Click on import image. Select this is the image we'll be using for today, then accept it. Okay, now if you watch, now this is our image, this is the image we'll be using. So let's get started. So click on your layer, drag this down, click and drag down, double click, duplicate it off the down layer, then you reduce this one, just click on it and drag back. You drag it, you reduce it to your preferred size, then you click on the empty layer, which is above the two layers. So now let's pick our drawing to, which is our pencil, and click here. I normally use this pen for drawing, this Fountain pen. Then go to your setting. This is my setting. Always make it opacity 100. Then the size should be around 1 or 1.2. Depend on the size you want. I will advise you use 1.0. Okay, then exit here. Click on the middle, swap down to black, then exit this. Then zoom in so that you can see your line very well. Then for the beginners, I would advise you use your pre-editing tool to enable you draw perfectly. Click on your pre-editing tool. Alright, so you swipe down, then you draw. Try to sketch very well. For the beginners, you find it difficult to sketch, okay, but try to be consistent, don't give up. If you watch even my own now, because of the tutorial, it's not straight, but I will try to make it straight. So for you guys, try and sketch very well. So I don't want to take much time on this, that is why I'm rushing it now. So just zoom in and make a sketch. Just zoom in and make a sketch. Just zoom in and make a sketch. Try and zoom in and make your sketch. Correct that mistake. So just try and draw very well. I think we just correct it now. Note the two arrow at the bottom are your redo and undo. Okay, those are the two arrow at the bottom here. So just take your time, don't rush it. Try to take your time and draw it perfectly. Just follow your line so that you can sketch very well. You outline your scene on the reference. That's what you follow to sketch. If you watch now, this is the finger. Nay, that's what I just drew now. So just follow it like this. So just follow it serially to give it a perfect drawing. You can click on your eraser to clean any mistake. Just draw, make sure you are drawing it perfectly. Don't rush it. If you rush it, you miss it. Do not get it accurate. So there's no need for a rush. Just take your time, you get it. one thing about drawing is the more you draw, the more you get it. Like, the more you practice, the more you get it. When I first started, my art was too bad, but I keep moving. So, don't give up on your artwork. And always ensure to post your work for review. That is where you will get more detail, like where you make it, you where you are not getting it. The professionals will tell you, then you make corrections. So we are moving now. Ensure to draw everything you are seeing. Ensure to draw everything to you are seeing. So we are going gradually. We are going gradually. Gradually. Just zoom in so that you can see the edges very well. Try and zoom in so that you can see the edges very well. I think I should pause the video so that I can go through the sketch before I will start again. So just follow it serially like this. You will get it. Some persons don't sketch, but I sketch on my smudge painting. Some persons don't sketch, but I do sketch. Then when I post my work, they will be asking, is this digital or smudge painting? I tell them that this smudge painting. The reason why is they see some of the work, like if it were to be smooth, it will not come out like that. So that is why they are asking if it's digital or smooth printing. So I advise you sketch first. Because when you are good now, if client gives you work, you should be able to deliver this sketch to the client before 1 or before 2 hours. One hour maximum. 2 hours will be too much. they cannot wait. They will think, ah, maybe this guy self not even know work. So at least 1 hour 30 minutes should be back with the sketch. So let's draw. Let's try and follow whatever we are seeing here. Just follow it, follow it. Let's try and follow it. It's already 16 minutes now for this sketch. Some places do ask me how many hours do I spend on my art work. I tell them it depends. There are some art work that does not need much time. Like, you cannot compare female art work with me. Me is just the hair. Don't have much doesn't require much detailing compared to that of so try and follow the sketch perfectly. Because if your sketch is cool, your art will be cool too. So that is the secret. That is why I always advise people not to rush art. So to all our subscribers, we love you all. If not for you, we want to meet up with the numbers of subscribers we have today. We really appreciate you all for your time and your willingness to support us. We love you all. Promise to serve you all better. Just make sure you on your notifications so that whenever we upload new videos, you'll be the first to receive it. is it coming out? Just follow this step I'm giving you now to sketch your work so that you look perfect. Ensure you follow it gradually. Just zoom in so that you can draw your outline perfectly. This video will be taking a lot of like to be too long. I will try my possible best to upload it the way it is. Will not trim out any place. And I'm not going to pause or skip any place as well, so that you guys can get it once. So this is it. think I will pause the video for the sake of time. Because I don't want to make this video in series. I want to upload it once and for all. So I will be pausing it for now. So let me just leave it. I want to skip any parts. So you can get it once and for all. These parts, the hair part, doesn't need too much attention, like trying to perfect it, because you paint everything off. So what you even need is just to try and get this sketch, okay? You don't need much. a perfect sketch, because when you are painting it, you paint it well. So you don't need too much attention here. We just try and follow the This is just a sketch, okay? Just a sketch. Pick an eraser to clean it up. Alright, we are done with the sketch now. Turn it off to check. We'll come down here. Yes. Make sure you are on the right layer. So you can turn off it, turn off. I think we've now completed the sketch. Okay. Just take note of my my screen. Just wash it carefully because I enable my touch screen so that you can see whatever I'm doing. So this is it. Discuss. So here is the sketch. So what we do next, let's try and clean off the overlap spaces. Any mistake you see, clean it off. Pick your soft airbrush, reduce the size. Then pick your eraser, come back, click your, pick your soft airbrush. So this is our sketch. We are done with the sketch. So let's try and create the eyes and the hair. So first of all, let's tackle the aspect of the hair. So what we do now, add in another layer. Okay, at the top or beneath. Well, let's leave it at the top. So what you do now, just swap down to your flat pen. That's what I use for my filling. Okay, you feel just feel like this. This is how you do it. Feel across. reduce the opacity and clean off the overlap space. Clean it off. Please, no rushing, please. Because if you rush it now, you make a lot of mistakes, so don't rush. I advise you don't rush. It's only when you are a professional, it will be hard for them to notice your mistake, because any of your mistake will be assumed that is a design you initially you purposely made a mistake, like you added it yourself. But now that you are learning, people have not seen your work, so if they see you upload art, they will be like, the guy that they draw to, let's go and check. So them checking and they are seeing rubbish on your status or wherever you be uploading it to. So this guy is safe. Think they're gonna draw again. All this kind of stuff. So you should take your time and give art your best. So you cannot increase. Notice now we need to clean here to lap it up, then go back, reduce and fill it out. So this is our art. This is sketch. So you cannot clean off these edges because we don't need it. Okay, first, before we do that, let's click on our soft airbrush to reduce the edges. Let's make it like this. Fading it a little bit. So now go back here to your main sketch, which is this, the main sketch, and clean this outline off because you don't need it any longer. Clean this off. as for the aspect of your hair drying. I'm not done yet. Not done yet. Still come back and make some correction. So try to make the edges blend, look like. Alright, remove this. See now our work is coming out gradually. So that is for the first part of the hair. Okay, I think we move ahead with to the eye. Okay, let's draw the BS. We take it up, adding another layer on the bottom of the hair. Just click, and this is the brush I use for my hair. This Trony. Click, swap, gradually, gradually, gradually. So that is it. So you go back, just of this, go back now, reduce the opacity. And pick your cleaner, add eraser to erase the unwanted part. So that is how we draw our BS. Note, this brush is not used for all the kind of like all BS. Okay, at times you are required to draw it one by one. At times you can just use this to fill it, depend on the kind of BS the person has. Okay, so you can now come back here, increase it. Let's see these edges. Seems a line here. Okay. So just ensure you follow the steps I'm giving you now, so that you won't be left out. cotton and bears now. Now, one thing I want to bring to your notice, most time auto decks do misbehave, okay? So whenever you are working, try to be saving your work, like try and save your art. Just turn this off, swipe down, just click here, sketch update, just click on it. That's what I'm saying now, it's not even responding. Click on this. Save. And here is it. Can just rename it to whatever you want. You should change it to tutorial. So click on it again. Then now let's go and bring the color palette we'll be using for the skin and the eyes. I already taught you guys how to import, so let me locate my palette, color palette. Alright, I'll be making use of this. For the eye, and I'll be making use of this. Making use of this for the skin. So those are the two color palettes we'll be using. So I can off this now, but it's not yet time for the skin. Then for this, I will click on my color picker, swipe down to Dix. Sorry, but before that, we need to outline our eyes. Okay. Let's quickly do that now before we start the eye detailing. Then off this, come back to your reference on it. On your pre-editing tool to give you the correct drawing. So now make sure whenever you are drawing, the eyes should be on a separate layer too. So I think we add it on the bottom of the BS. So you add in a new layer here. The same as this. So make sure the way you are drawing should close the edges, which is there should be no space. So that as soon as you feel it, do not go across the eyes. So that is for the eye. That is for the eyes. all this, and I do make use of this. This particular color, now you can find it on your color palette, BV01. So let me go and show you guys from the color palette. Just click here, down to copy BV01. This is the color here from your Illustrator, the first color at the top. Okay, so all colors that are there now are on your color palette. I just want to save the time of going through all those stuff. That's why I just always import this. I just pick it. So that is it. So now what we'll be doing is just disable this of that eye layer. So you swipe down to off this. Then you zoom, then go to your airbrush, hard airbrush, that's what we'll be using, and increase, then make sure you lock this layer, the eye layer, you lock it so that it will not go outside the eyes. So you start painting like this. So that's for the eyes. You turn this on, you turn this off, then you create another layer at the top to draw your black, which is the eyebrow, and go back to your black, just swap down to black color, then pick this your to guidance, click on guidance, set it, reduce it, just set it to make sure it fits with the eyes. So you draw, you do same with this one. So you feel to kind of feel it, to feel, you feel, then you on this very one, then you bring this opacity down so that you can see where you need to clean off. So click on a hard eraser to clean it off. So you clean like this. Just increase it. Once you go back again to clean any side, you need to be clean too. So this is your eyes, this is how you draw the eyes. Okay. And now and see our drawing is coming out gradually. So what we do next is to add the eye effect. Turn this on, turn this off, turn this off. Then you create another layer on top of the black color. Then you swap down to white because it's what you need. Then go to this pencil part. That's what I use for my eye detailing. Just swap, just drag, just drag. That's how I draw it. Just drag like this. You can now go on it. On it. So that's it. So that's how I draw it. Okay, now let's move ahead to the skin, and the color we'll be using for the skin is this particular one, this color here. This is the color we'll be using for the skin. Is the color we'll be using for the skin. The second color. So you click on your flat pen to fill it. So you cannot draw across. So now you create a new layer under the whole sketch, the bears, the eye and all that. You create a layer that is above, below all. Okay, so this is our color for the skin. So just paint around. Bring it across like this. Don't worry about those edges. We'll clean it off. Clean it off. So you click on your hard eraser and you start cleaning it off. Let's clean it. We'll feed those edges back, so just make sure you clean the corner so that you know overlap color there. just clean the part you don't need off. So let's turn back and fill the part we need. Just reduce the size. Just try and clean your work. Just try and clean your work properly so that your art will be cool. And make sure you paint properly too. To do this video all in one, like I don't want to skip any part and say let's come back for part two. I want to put everything in one, all in one video. The sketch, you paint, adding effect, that's it. Don't want to skip any part and say. Because I wish I made the complete tutorial for that other video. Wouldn't have still been making this now. Maybe I would have showed you guys how to draw Fimi hair. At least. You have to get one hair before you move to another. If not, you just miss all of it. So let's clean this part off. can decide to fill it gradually, like you don't want to follow the procedure used so far. You fill it properly, and no problem, but ensure you fill it well and you clean it well so that you don't have loopholes like the way it is now. Close all these edges. I just paint gradually the way I'm doing now. Alright, this is our complete art, okay. Alright, then what we do next is let's try and fill in black color. Just fill it. Let's clean it off. Ensure to fit all your spaces. Again with the filling of the edges, just try and close it very well. persons will not bother of this corner. What I do, and that's what makes my heart cool. So yeah, it's our ads. We almost done. Okay, now we cannot off this, Okay, then turn on this. So now let's increase the opacity because we need it now. Okay, then what we do is let's off this, Okay, because we need everything the way it is. So let's move straight now and lock it. So what you do now is you click on your smudge brush, then you increase or decrease depend on how you zoom it. So let's get started. Smudge it perfectly. You can see it's coming out now. Increase it. Always know when to increase and decrease it. That's what matters. Always know when to increase and decrease it. So don't rush this aspect because this particular art is a technical one. I just choose to like give you guys this one so that you don't see this kind of work and you run away. No. So just move it gradually. Don't be scared of work. Any work you see, if you cannot do it, even if you cannot collect the work, just tell the person, send me the picture. Then you try it on your own. Maybe in case of next time, not for victim of losing that client. Okay? So let's do it together. Ensure you are increasing and decreasing your brush. Depends on how you zoom, okay? That's how you smudge. Smooth it perfectly, don't rush it. So you rush it, you miss it. Smooth it, just take your time and do it gradually. Though I'm rushing this one anyway. I'm rushing it, but when you will do yours, just try and do it gradually. And for this picture, I saw it on Facebook. Can't actually remember where I got it from, but I know I saw this picture. I got it from Facebook. So, there come a poor copyright striker on my channel. So, I saw it on Facebook and I feel. Let me just use it for tutorial because I love the body structure. I said I should just try it. Take it gradually, gradually, don't rush it so that you won't miss it. So you smooshed perfectly the way I'm doing it now. Ensure you do it gradually, don't rush it, please. So our next tutorial will be on Vimeo. Okay, so make sure you stay tuned. Now we'll be dropping them one after the other. I have a lot of tutorial, but time is what is keeping me not be able to upload and make them. I have a lot of video on my am I to make this month, but time, there's no time. But I will try and manage the time to be able to post and make those videos. I love sharing knowledge with others, but I've met several persons, but whenever I tell them to like show me how they do it, not like teaching me how did they do it, where, what software did they use, what app did they use, be like burn money. And that is why most time if you ask me, I say bring money too, because it's just as if I'm just giving, nobody's out there to give me. So that's one thing. And data too is one thing. Data is expensive now, but if you all can be patient, I'll be dropping them one after the other on my channel. So if you have not subscribed yet, ensure you do so, because we still have a lot of video, like important stuff to upload that you can't get anywhere. Even if you will get it, do not be like our own. You might get it, but it's not be detailed like the way we are doing it. So ensure you subscribe to our channel. And to my boss that taught me at 360 graphics, taught me how to do this. It took his time, like since I've been asking people to teach me how to do this stuff, nobody have ever taught me the way he did. I pay money to several persons, but they end up eating my money. But when I met this guy, he taught me, he gave me time, always correct me, always guide me. Not like your work is not final, go and start afresh. You see, your work is cool anyway, but why not you do it like this? Would I be okay, more okay if you do it like this? Or some persons will just condemn the free work, like as if you did not even spend time on it. You now feel bad. So don't feel bad whenever they criticize you or they say your work, your art is not okay. It should be a thing of challenge to you that, let me try and even meet up with this thing. Those guys, when they say my artwork not okay, I can still prove them wrong. All this kind of stuff. So that should be your motivation. Whenever you post your work and somebody's out there criticizing you, like your work is not okay, it should be your motivation, should be what will drive you to strive more, to know it well and more better. So just take your time and do this much, like the way I'm doing it now. Just take your time, ensure you increase or decrease the brush whenever it's needed for you to decrease. If not, just smudge off everything that will not cost you more. You now go extra mile kind of shading again. But if you follow the flow of the image, you will not spend much time like doing digital work, because if you smooth away the parts you are not supposed to smooth, not cost you more, you're not going to start using your airbrush and all that to start detailing your art. But this one, you will not. Just follow the flow gradually. When I posted this work last night, because I've done this work now before, some persons were complaining, why not I go and create my own group and teach others. I was like, are you serious? Has it gotten to that? I said, yes, now because you are now a professional. I said, no, I'm still learning now. I've not gotten what I want. So, but since the sixth, as I'm giving it out now, so let's learn together. Teach me, I teach you, that's how it goes. I'm not. It's not long like I start this artwork. It's not up to a year now. Not up to a year. Just started early, was it August last year? Or thereabouts. But now. Was it even August? I can't really remember, but I know it's not up to a year. It should be around, is it up to 6 months now? I can't even remember. So you just smudge it perfectly like this. This is not perfect, but try to make it perfect because I'm rushing the video now. Look at the length of the video. So I'm trying to rush it now. First, we get to 2 hours.